Welcome back to Fear 2. My internet is currently half functional, which means I can't watch any streams. So instead of being lazy and just watching streams all morning, I guess I'll play video games instead. Ah, my life is so hard. Ow. I'm gonna die on the ladder, aren't I? Nope, I'm good. Your move. What are you gonna do? Huh? Huh? Bulletproof glass, mofo? I kind of feel bad about that. Poor guy. I should have just shot him and put him out of his misery. Gotta keep my strength up. Oh yeah, the napalm cannon. That gun is terrible. What guns do I have again? Alright. So I guess I really don't need both a rocket launcher and this thing. I mean, this thing seems pretty much as powerful, or even probably more powerful than a rocket launcher in terms of damage. Although the travel time of the... Well, it's not a bullet. The travel time of the projectile, let's call it, is extremely long. But it does a lot of damage. Either way, the napalm cannon is freaking terrible, so... Nope. I'll take redundant heavy weapons over a napalm cannon. Target sighted! Requesting backup. Oh, whoa, holy shit! How much health did I have? Damn.
Squad report. No contact.
Yeah, just a tip for you, buddy. Don't come into battle with your back to me. It's not wise. Well, I guess that tip's gonna fall on deaf ears, isn't it? Oh! Oh crap. Okay. Wait for it. Did it work? Okay. Silent but deadly. I'll take it. Man, these dudes are doing so much damage. I've only got one medkit. Half health, no armor. I'm probably gonna die in one hit. I really don't want to use my medkit, though. Now with only one. Oh, here we go. Oh no, I trapped his arm. I'm sorry. That was rude of me. Oh hey! It's Exposition Man's head. Who put your head here? Weird. I mean, I've heard of giving head, but that takes it to a whole new level. Now I kind of wish I had my shotgun. Let's go full auto with this. Because these are melee dudes. This place is really gorgeous looking. Oh shit. Did I break that or was that always empty? I don't know, but this place is really cool looking. Look at this. Distorted little bubble circle things, and looks like there's water coming down the side here. It's really pretty. Bye! Was I supposed to fight that thing? I don't know, I just completely skipped it. It ran out and I ran in.
I hope you're on your way, Beckett. We've got enemy forces converging from all over.
Get to the APC? What APC? Okay, I'll get to the APC. They can't see through this, right? No, they can't see through this. Can I shoot through this? Guy makes some loud movements. It's gotta be a super heavy armor. Confirmed. You can shoot through it. Oh, it's the APC. Let's go!
Into the APC, we gotta go. Come on, come on! We're good, Manny, punch it!
I saw what happened to Halford. There was nothing you could have done. Let's take a look at Snake Fist's data. The son of a bitch was true to his word. He gave us more than enough to sink Armacam forever. Assuming we survive long enough.
I completed the Snake Fist Award. Awesome. Snake Fist is dead. Killed by Ripley.
I'll skip the metaphysics and try to keep this as simple as possible. Sergeant Beckett, Genevieve Aristide did some nasty things to you back at that medical facility. First came the gene splicing operation to link you to Alma. Then she tricked you into getting into the telesthetic attunement chamber, which strengthened the link. That's why Alma's aware of you, and why you're totally pooch-screwed unless you can destroy her. Which brings me to the telesthetic amplifier on Still Island. You're not psychically potent enough to resist Alma, so we're going to plug you into a device that will crank up your brainwaves. Sadly, the only device that has enough juice for the job is on Still Island, hidden inside the old nuclear reactor. My belief is that the amplifier will theoretically make you powerful enough to defeat Alma in a battle of wills. I say theoretically because my data on Alma is a little sketchy at this point, but the odds are better than somebody's head explodes. It'll be hers and not yours.
Seems pretty straightforward. Find the psychic amplifier, plug Beckett into it, flip the switch, and Alma's history.
So, Still Island, huh? I thought they shut the reactor down like 30 or 40 years ago.
That must have been when Armacam moved in.
According to Snake Fist's data, it's the main testing area for Project Origin. How far out are we, Manny?
15 minutes if the roads are clear. Holy shit!
And that's why you wear seatbelts.
Manny, what the hell is going on?
Sorry, Lieutenant. Looks like we really stepped in the shit here. We have enemy Multiple enemy targets bearing down on our position. Looks like replicas, and they're pissed.
Sergeant, get us out of here.
We don't have a lot of options. Wait, up ahead. Oh man, I don't know.
What?
You better grab a hold of something. I've got an idea.
Whoa. What is that supposed to mean?
Going down, hang on. Street station, now boarding.
Subway. Good work, Sergeant.
Manny, you crazy son of a bitch.
Beckett, man that turret and cover us. We need to figure out where we are.
Deacon, you're up. Beckett, cover up.
What's happening?
Move up! Now!
Cool.
Kagan, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't be afraid.
We don't have time for this shit, man. Pull yourself together.
Kagan, snap out of it.
Don't leave.
Kagan, God damn it. Becca, get him back here.
Where are you going?
Oh, he's dead. Even the rats are running away. I get you. Gotta go from up above, it looks like. Auburn District's woes linked to military contractor malfeasance. Improper disposal of hazardous materials at a classified facility beneath the Auburn District caused a variety of symptoms reported by area residents over the past 20 years. According to an anonymous source who provided extensive documentation in support of the allegations, the source claims that the Auburn Technology Corporation suspended operations of the facility almost 2 decades ago without removing potential contaminants. The facility was briefly reopened earlier this year before being promptly shut down again due to an industrial accident. I think I'm going to replace my rocket launcher. Given that I have this amazing energy weapon. Yeah. And I've only used the automatic shotgun once, and I didn't use it in combat, I just tested it out and didn't really like it very much. But, let me give it a real use. I'll probably use it against these dudes that get close to me. It shoots a little bit too slowly. Killed him in 2 hits. Not bad. Cut him in half. Ew. Just the sound this thing makes. I thought I heard something. Bastard. They sound like insects when you start shooting them. Oh, wow. I thought they were just normal dudes wearing, like, super advanced masks, but... they're actually, like, really creepy. Alright, that's where I'm supposed to go, but I believe this way is the upgrade. For my slow-mo juice. Yes. Yeah, I don't like this thing that much. I want to be able to shoot these enemies from afar. Because as soon as they get close to me, then they're about to attack me. I'd rather kill them before they get within range. Oh, it's a cute little skeleton! I love skeletons. Until the city sends someone to repair the sewer leak near the Madison Park station, be extremely careful not to step in puddles on the tracks. Aside from the obvious disadvantages of waiting around in raw sewage, you could also be electrocuted.
Keegan's readings are looking a little strange. I must be getting interference.
Is that the Popo?
Do you see him? Keep your eyes open!
I don't think heads are supposed to bend that way. Ow. Wait, what? Wait, what? Okay, I officially do not understand how this weapon works. I did just turn this dude into a nice, darkened, beautiful skeleton, though. So cute. Okay, what was that noise? That sounded like somebody nasty and big. It sounded like a monster.
Thank you.
What am I hearing in there? I'm just going full auto. These are relatively close quarters, and these dudes take a lot of hits. I like how the pump room is notated with, like, scraps. What even is this? Is this paper? Or, like, a piece of... Oh, it's a piece of cardboard, isn't it? I think it's a bit of cardboard. But, like, this is really unprofessional. Freaking hand-drawn on a scrap of dirty cardboard. And then nailed into... Wait, is that nailed into concrete? What? I don't think you can do that. Sounds like it's a zombie. Alright, that doesn't seem safe. Nah. Let's safeify it. Ow. All right, shotgun time. I love the reload sound and animation for this automatic shotgun. Look at it. Very cool.
Second, Manny managed to get the ATC out of the tunnel. We'll try to rendezvous with you at King Street Station.
Don't need any of that. Damn. No, they threw a grenade. Ow. Alright, I'm going back for the armor. Thank you.
check in.
Every time I hear a tink noise, I just assume it's a grenade and just try to move. Even though oftentimes, like right there, it wasn't. I think I just hit a bottle with my foot or something. Okay, invincible. Cool. Award unlocked, Snake Fist! That was really dangerous, because that dude might have had a shotgun, and if he shot me once from that range with no armor, I'd be totally dead. Mmm, burger. Oh god. Mmm, burger. Clog. Okay. One hit, one kill. Ow. Didn't even stand a damn chance. I don't have to replay the entire section, do I? No, good. Oh. Right, I didn't turn off the power, that's why the mines are exploding. That's not what I meant to shoot. What am I even doing? Oh god! Ow, it hurts! I used the wrong everything there. Oh god. Alright, so he's got a laser beam, which I... Oh, that's the... what was it called? The laser carbine or something? From the original F.E.A.R. So I think I'm gonna get to use a new weapon. Okay, so as soon as I turn off the power, they literally instantly spawn. So, we're gonna do this. And then we're gonna do this. Just make sure they're dead. They're dead. Laser. Okay, so they simplify the name. Laser carbine, or whatever it was before. It was too complicated. It's just laser. Alright, let's replace my auto shotgun. Ooh. The laser gun, or just laser, has a laser sight. How ironical. Laser full. Also, am I crazy, or is that laser sight fucking weird? Why is it pointing at, like, the top left of the screen? That is... what is it doing? That is not the center of my screen. Isn't it supposed to point at the center of my screen? That is freaking weird. Is it actually accurate? It is. Okay. That is so weird. What kind of a gun doesn't point at the center of your screen? Is it because the freaking weapon model is so huge that they decided that if it actually pointed at the center of the screen, you wouldn't be able to see what you're shooting at? I don't know, that's really strange. I mean, look at that. That's the center. And that's where the laser points. Sounds freaking awesome, though. Let's give this thing a shot. Ah, the classic. The hole in the stairs that you fall down and you can't get back up. Let me guess, this is a level transition? Oh, it's not. Underground transport system, supply delivery schedule. So they're transporting illegal stuff, I suppose, probably down here. Body bags, epidural trays, pillows, and an unspecified machine. As much as I want to use this laser, I really want to see how effective it is against enemies. I think I should end this episode here before it becomes too long. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back. Soon.